It's time for...
Spill the Tea!
We are going to be testing the limits of your mind, your memory, your ability to learn, to recall, and to retell. The contestants are going to hear a story and then take turns sharing it with the next person. They're going to be waiting in another room so you don't hear what the original story was. TWA, Boeing 747, had just taken off from Miami International Airport for Los Angeles when a passenger near the rear of the aircraft announced that the plane was being taken over by the People's Revolutionary Army for the liberation of the oppressed. The hijacker held a 357 Magnum to the head of Jack Swanson, a flight attendant, and forced him to open the cockpit door. There, the hijacker confronted the pilot, Jane Randall, and ordered her to change course for Cuba. The pilot radioed the Miami Air Traffic Control Center to report the situation, but then suddenly hurled a microphone at the hijacker. The hijacker fell backward through the open cockpit door and onto the floor, where angry passengers took over from there. The plane landed in Miami a few minutes later, and the hijacker was arrested.
A Boeing 747 was traveling from Miami International Airport to LAX in Los Angeles. When a hijacker towards the rear of the plane from the People's Terrorist Group.
That's the name of the terrorist group, the People's Terrorist Group?
That's the one I remember. He took a what kind of a Magnum was it? A 451 Magnum? He took a big gun, it's like a big handgun, it's a Magnum handgun, to a flight attendant's head. His name is Jack Swanson. He brought him from the back of the plane to the front of the plane and demanded that the pilot open up the cockpit door. So the pilot does, and then the terrorist demands that the flight be rerouted to Cuba. But as that's happening, somebody takes a microphone and throws it at the terrorist. He like falls backwards, and then the crew of the flight regains control of the airplane, and they land safely at back in Miami International Airport.
So a Boeing 747 is flying from Miami International Airport to LAX. On the flight, in the air, in mid-flight, a terrorist from the People's Terrorist Group pulls out a Magnum, some kind of number, we don't remember, but it's a big gun. He takes hostage a flight attendant, a male flight attendant named Jack Swanson, which I only remember because of Ron Swanson from Park and Recreations. So he takes him hostage and pulls him from the back of the plane to the front of the plane to get into the cockpit, using the stewardess, well, flight attendant, to tell the pilot to open the door to the cockpit so he can go in. The pilot lets them in because he doesn't want his flight attendant to die. As he's pointing the gun at the flight attendant, he wants them to redirect the flight to Cuba.
Who wants to direct him?
The terrorist wants to redirect. The flight attendant just really wants to go to Cuba. He might as well use it as the last wish.
The terrorist
wants to go to Cuba. Okay. But in mid-conversation, somebody takes a
microphone. Between the three of them?
I don't know. Somebody throws a microphone at the terrorist and it hits the terrorist. I guess either the pilot or the flight attendant was able to get control of the gun, so control of the plane got back to them, so they re-landed into Miami International Airport.
Okay, so there is a flight going from Miami to from Miami to LAX. On the flight, there is a terrorist from the People's Terrorist Group.
That name he made up. The worst name that you could come up with.
That was the thing that I remember the most because it was the most ridiculous thing. And so the terrorist is on this flight and captures one of the flight attendants as his hostage. named Ross Swanson. And he has a magnum, and he drags the flight attendant from the back of the plane to the front of the plane to get into the cockpit. And between the flight attendant, the terrorist, and the pilot, they're in this cockpit, and the terrorist says, "I want to redirect the flight to Cuba." Okay.
judging the People's Terrorist Group, are ya? Yeah.
Somehow, this microphone is and hits the terrorist. And they were able to avoid getting diverted to Cuba, and the pilot lands the plane in Miami.
So let me read the actual story to all of you. So the plane was being taken over by the People's Revolutionary Army for the Liberation of the Oppressed.
I couldn't remember.
So the opposite of the People's Terrorist Group.
The hijacker held a .357 Magnum. There, the hijacker confronted the pilot, Jane Randall, and ordered her to change course for Cuba.
I forgot the...
Jane Randall, the pilot's name?
I forgot the pilot's name, and I forgot the People's Terrorist
Revolutionary Army for the Liberation of the Oppressed. Come on! As a group, we did well, but we failed because Colin failed. And not because of anyone else.
I probably had to remember like 15 key things. Yes. I think you only had to remember about 10 or 11.
Yeah, I agree. I think at each time, as each person had to remember the next thing, we had to remember fewer number of things.
So what you all are describing here is leveling. And that's each time we remember a memory, certain details drop off, and it's kind of simplified. So a lot of the details about the Boeing plane, TWA, the pilot, who the person is, some of these details get leveled off and they get simplified.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But at the same time, certain things carried throughout everyone.
Like the People's Terrorist Group.
The word terrorist was never mentioned in the original script.
Oh.
I think it's like an anecdotal association, right?
Like a hijacker
on a plane, we tend to associate that with a terrorist.
Yeah, that's assimilation. That's where we take information and we combine it with stuff we already know to sort of fill in the blanks there. Mm-hmm. So the word terrorist wasn't mentioned, but it's something that often comes up in the story because it's a part of these ideas that we have about hijackers. There's a lot of stuff like Cuba, that there was a hijacking, the flight attendant, a lot of that stuff really stuck out, and we call that sharpening, where certain details really stick out in a story and they carry through.
Yeah.
And that sort of did happen here.
Yeah.
Yes, it did.
We think that memory is this perfect recollection, this perfect record, like we're passing this paper back and forth, but it's not. Every time we think of something, we recreate that memory, just like we did between each person. Mm-hmm. And each time we do, new information is added, certain details get sharpened, and some things get leveled off, and sometimes we add in our own stuff. Here's how you can play at home. Find a friend and ask them to recall a memory, an important event that you both experienced. Write down the details and then compare your notes.
Cool.
See how similar they are, what's been leveled, what's been sharpened, and what's been assimilated.
All of our memories will be different.
If you want more fun and easy to understand psychology, make sure you subscribe to The Psych Show. Let me know what you thought of this episode in the comments below. Give us a thumbs up. We'll see you in the next one.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.